SuperRare is built on the Ethereum blockchain, where every unique piece that's minted is forever inscribed. Whenever an artwork here is sold, that transaction is done in Ether, or ETH, the cryptocurrency native to Ethereum. To establish a collector account on SuperRare, you need an Ethereum crypto wallet. Crypto wallets do indeed feel like wallets in that they are a tool for storing currencies, but they also function a bit like passports. They act as your entry into the world of ETH, an ID that you flash at the gates of Web3. Today, we're going to show you how to set up a wallet. Most wallets come in the form of both browser extensions and mobile apps. We'll start on desktop today with MetaMask, arguably the most popular wallet amongst our community and the world of NFTs. To install MetaMask, head over to metamask.io, and you'll find an option to download in the top right corner. Be sure you're at the right website for the wallet that you're after. In this case, metamask.io is your source of truth. As with anything around the web, it's important to double check that what you're installing is legit. You'll want to be sure you have one of the supported browsers compatible with MetaMask. The same goes for any other wallet you want to use in the future. In this case, I'm using Chrome. I've already added it here, but you'll see a little Add to Chrome button here. Hit that and follow the instructions. Once installed, your browser will open up to a page that gives you two options: reboot an existing wallet or create an entirely new one. For this case, we'll start a new one. Agree. To get familiar with all the information on how to secure your wallet, watch this minute and a half video to get your footing. A seed phrase is a unique 12-word phrase that's generated when you first set up a crypto wallet. If you ever lose your password, your seed phrase allows you to recover your wallet and your funds. And when you set up your wallet on a new browser or piece of hardware, like on mobile for example, you will use your seed phrase to unlock your account. Because seed phrases are the ultimate key to wallet recovery, MetaMask has started referring to them as secret recovery phrases to emphasize this core purpose. And because its purpose is directly tied to the security of your funds, safely storing your seed phrase for the long run is an essential step you need to take. Safeguarding this phrase, and in turn your wallet, is your responsibility. Write it down on paper and put it in a safety deposit box or elsewhere for safekeeping. Or use a secure password manager. And do not share it with anyone, under any circumstances, no matter what anybody says. These are the seed phrase words here. Obviously, I'm not going to be using this wallet in the future, but this gives you an idea of what they look like. For this case, I'm going to write them down here because the next window is going to ask me to re-enter them into the confirmation page. Confirm. Congratulations. Read these tips here to better understand how to properly and safely store your secret recovery phrase. This section here will allow you to connect this wallet to your mobile MetaMask wallet. We won't cover this today, but understanding it here is a great way to get started on mobile. Now we see here the first account is the one that you automatically have. This wallet hash address here is your public address. If somebody wants to send you funds, or send you NFTs, or send you anything to your wallet, this is the address that you will send them. You can rename your account details here. Now, let's go back to SuperRare to get connected with a new account. You're going to want to sign in here at the top right and select a wallet. For this case, we will use MetaMask up here. MetaMask will pop up here and ask you to connect your MetaMask wallet to SuperRare. Obviously, you don't have an account set up with SuperRare yet. That's what this message means. Down here, you will sign up instead. Username, srdemo. Email address here. Opt into the newsletter if you want to hear more about everything that goes on at SuperRare. MetaMask will once again pop up and ask you to sign the transaction. This is in place of using a password. The next step to being able to collect artwork on SuperRare is to fund your MetaMask wallet. As we mentioned earlier, this public address is where you're going to send funds to. If you have a crypto account on, say, Coinbase, you will then send ETH directly to this wallet via your Coinbase profile. Once you've filled up your wallet with ETH, you will be ready to go on SuperRare and collect the next generation of crypto art. Thanks for tuning in, and let us know if you have any questions.